want to hear a story, kindergartners?
Yeah.
Tell us a story.
I'll tell you a story how I became a kindergarten teacher.
You mean you weren't always a teacher?
Oh my goodness, but my first job was with the agency that trained big bad wolves.
But you're not big and bad?
That's all because of a little girl named Little Red Riding Hood.
Little Red Riding Hood?
Yes, it happened about 30 years ago with the agency, my very first job. Little Red Riding Hood had just arrived at her grandmother's house with a basket full of goodies. I was hiding in her grandmother's bed, waiting for her to show up and...
Grandma, it's me, Little Red Riding Hood. I brought you some goodies from Gretel's Cookie Shop.
Is that you, Little Red Riding Hood? Please come in.
Hi, Grandma. Wait, something's different about you.
Why, whatever, dear.
No, something's definitely different. Is it your eyes? Did you get contacts?
Come here, dear. Granny's very hungry.
Is it your teeth? Is that new lipstick you're wearing?
Come, dear.
I know, it's your hair. You got a perm.
Oh, for goodness sake, take a better look.
Hey, what did you do with my... dang it. Hey, you're not my grandma, you're a wolf.
Finally, that's over.
Back up, Buster. I have my cell phone set to call 911. What did you do with my grandma?
Nothing. She was gone when I got here.
So what are you still doing here?
Well, according to my job sheet, I'm supposed to eat your grandma, dress up in her clothes, and then eat you when you show up.
Your job sheet?
It's a long story, kid.
I have the time.
Well, ever since I was a little pup.
Cookie?
My parents wanted me to join the Kennel Order of Obnoxious and Devious Wolves. Food for short. My dad was in it, and so was my dad's dad. Wolves that you read about in all the papers, you know, the ones that eat little kids, blow down buildings, terrorize little pigs. I'm sure you heard of them.
Yes, I have. But you don't seem their type.
Well, the truth is, quite kindly.
Hello, you're Grandma's neighbor, the woodcutter, right?
Yes. I am taking your grandmother's away while I'm here. To check on you. I heard there's a wolf wandering about here.
No, everything's just fine.
Are you sure? I could come in and check for you.
No, that's okay. You want a cookie?
Sure.
Thanks again, and goodbye.
That was a close one. I think that was the same guy that left his two kids out in the woods not too long ago.
No, you're probably thinking of Hansel and Gretel. Now please, continue your story.
Well, I did join food because somehow my boss found out that I used to babysit the kids in my neighborhood, and he thought I might like eating them. I like kids, but not as food.
Phew, that's a relief.
This was my first job, and now look what happened. You know what is going to happen if the fraternal brothers find out, my whole profession, I'll be disgraced on my whole profession. Not again.
Who is it?
It's Goldilocks. Is that you, Red?
Goldilocks! Run into any bears lately?
Ha ha. Very funny. Actually, I'm selling cookies for my school so we can buy more porridge making equipment. Wanna buy a few dozen? They're great.
Actually, my grandma isn't here right at the moment, and I don't have any money.
Hey, what's that I smell? Do you have any porridge? It's been a long time since I've had any of that.
No, you're probably just smelling my grandma's new perfume. She sprays it everywhere.
No, it's not good. It actually smells like a bear or a wolf or something.
Well, grandma sprays her new perfume everywhere so that she can smell more woodsy and blend into the forest surroundings. Take care, and good luck on your cookie sales.
Gee, that was a little too close. I have to get out of here.
Actually, I have an idea. You like kids, right?
Yeah, it's a little embarrassing me being a wolf and all, but there's something fun being around them.
And you don't like eating them, right?
Yuck, no, I was never much of a meat eater.
I think this might just work.
Wait, what are you thinking of?
Open up, it's Inspector Frank Anfielder, private investigator.
Let me see your badge, please. Yes, how may I help you?
I've been hired by three little pigs to track down a big bad wolf, and I have reason to believe it may be here.
No, no big wolf, no big bad wolves here. Want a cookie?
No thanks, ma'am. I'm on duty. Are you sure you haven't seen any big bad wolves around? They can be mighty dangerous.
Uh-huh. No, sorry. No big bad wolves here.
They've been known to eat people, you know?
I know, but I have my cell phone with me and the woodcutter down the street that already checked that place out.
Are you really sure? I mean, completely, positively sure. Because the three little pigs are going to be upset if I come home and be hungry, and I only get paid if I find a wolf.
Well, I did see a wolf go that way. If you hurry, you can catch up with him.
Gee, thanks.
We don't have a lot of time. Here, take this.
What? Why?
Go back to food and tell them another wolf had already eaten me. And that was all that was left of me. Then sneak away to the next carriage to Albert Mill. My uncle lives there. I'll give him a call to meet you at the station.
Wait, slow down. What are you thinking of?
Have you ever thought about being a kindergartner teacher?
A teacher, certainly. I thought all about it, but I'm a wolf and all, and not even in my wildest dreams that I thought I would have a chance.
Well, it's hard work, and the pay is lousy.
That's okay. As long as I can work with kids and not eat them, I don't care.
Okay, off you go. Hi, Uncle Yellow. I have someone who wants to learn how to be a kindergarten teacher. He's clever and he's willing to do hard work.
Teacher herself.
Can you tell us another story?
Yeah, tell us another story.
Yeah, one about No other wolves that like to eat little pigs. Is it lunchtime yet?
No, I'll tell you another story another day. But everybody out for recess.